But let me go back to misdemeanor one time. And I have to go back to misdemeanor because that song, as I read, was actually done in the original sessions, as you mentioned, for the audition. But it didn't come out until like 2 years later as a solo record with Foster. So tell me how that all went down.
Well, when I did it on the audition, all of it wasn't done. It was just the first verse and chorus. And then we just kind of, so I didn't finish it, but I knew that was the best thing I had as far as reaction. When people hear it, it's like, and then the way I'd stomp with the bass playing, and the my younger sister saying, "Look, Jeff, setbacks."
Oh my God. Yeah.
It had a nice, and everybody be clapping and then pick up on the, it sounded great, just live with the bass.
What a record.
That's what did it.
Yeah.
We didn't play nothing else after that. The MGM started clapping, the people in there, Mike Lloyd, and that was it. It was done. So I knew what I had, but I didn't finish it because we had some other records. And he said, "Well, Mike Nina want to put that out now." And I was like, "Okay, let's do it. Foster and them do it." Okay, great idea. Let's do, you know. So, but he had to come to me first because me and him was real tight, you know, and he respected me as a writer more than anybody did. So I would give him that respect back, you know. And Mike Nina said, "Let's put it on Foster." And they didn't even make a name. They just said Foster Silvers.
Yeah.
And people thought it was a Foster group of Silvers that was trying to give us a reason why. And it's like using our sisters as background singers.
Right.
But it was a group. It was, you know, it was them three, you know.
Yep.
So they didn't make up. I guess Mike Vita just wanted to put that joint out quick. Foster Silvers. Yeah. Just put it out.
It was great. What an amazing record to this day. Just absolutely a classic record. And you know, what happens with a lot of classic records from back in the day, they get sampled. And this one most prominently with when Dr. Dre sampled it for his rapper.
D.O.C., yeah.
D.O.C. I think it was called Funky Enough or something like that. How did that make you feel when you heard that? Was that cool?
I mean, I heard it when I was at the gym playing basketball. Mm. Memorial Park basketball a couple of my friends came up and said, "Man, congratulations on your new hit." You know, new hit. I don't got nothing out now. "Yeah, you do. Yeah, Dre produced it. Your name is on it." And I was like, "What? What? I've never heard it. I didn't hear it." And then the guy, when it came on, he said, "There it is right there." And I heard it because they were playing it over in the gym.
Yeah.
And I said, "Oh, shoot." I was happy because I knew, more royalties. That's great.
That's right.
Ray producing it too. Whew.
Man.
That was great. I felt great when I heard that.